Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Roseline Kihamba. If you're here for the first time, ensure you click the subscribe button and also the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any video that comes up. And if you're a returning subscriber, I'm very delighted to have you here. Thank you for always supporting me. Thank you for viewing, sharing, commenting, and also for them that like. I also would like to request you to ensure that you tag along, especially them that have not yet discovered this channel. Today I'd like us to talk about red flags in relationship. 10 red flags that will, when you see them in your relationship, it is high time you be warned that something could be going wrong. Number one, communication. There is either no communication or the communication is not done properly. Selective communication. You choose what you want to talk about. You're not free enough with your partner to be able to talk about or discuss anything. The communication is not flowing. You find that you have hitches. Someone will just decide to keep to themselves some issues instead of bringing them to the table so that you discuss and sort them out. And when I talk about no communication, it's simply where there are cases where some people just disappear even for 2 weeks. There's no communication. They don't tell you where they are. They don't tell you what's going on in their life. And then there are also at times when the communication is not meaningful. With meaningful communication is where you're talking about things that are helping your relationship. But when you find yourself, you're just talking about, did it rain? Have you eaten? Did you talk to your mother? I mean, so petty. Number two is lies. When you talk about lies is when someone is just telling you lies about anything and about everything. It could be very small. Lie to you about their job. They lie to you about their life. It's just a lie. Lie here and there. And when it comes to lies, we also have cheating partners. If a partner cheats on you when you're not yet married, chances are they just continue with that habit even in marriage, and it is just daunting and hurting. Then number three is fear. When I talk about fear, this is when you're not yourself. I mean, you can't express yourself. You just fear this partner. Either maybe because you fear the outcome. When you say something, what will they, how will they respond? Or you fear how will they judge you. You know, you fear being judged. You fear how they will handle that relationship. You know, there's just fear. You also fear the relationship could end anytime. Fear of the unknown, the fear of, you know, when there's just fear ringing in your mind, it is a signal that something could just be so wrong, and you should ensure that you check on it. The next one is insecurity. With insecurity, this is when now your partner kind of does not have trust in you. Therefore, they want to snoop through your phone. They want to know where you are. You know, there's just some people who are like that. They're just insecure. You find that they'll even do some things and you might think, hey, my partner loves me. You know, they escort me wherever I go. But the underlying issue is they are insecure. It is not a good trait. It is not anything romantic when your partner is just all over you. Number five are the controlling traits or controlling partners. When a relationship has a controlling effect, this is when a partner feels like you should be theirs and for them alone. And so what they'll do, they'll try to alienate you from your significant others. If you're in a group of friends, you realize that they start drawing you away from your friends so that they have you to themselves. And they'll also try to control what you do. That is maybe the things that you like, your hobbies, they'll try to change them so that it fits to what they want. Number six is the exploitation in a relationship. If you find it is a one-sided thing, one-sided effort, it's only you making all the effort. You're the only one making effort to meet, to make the relationship work, or even in issues of resources, you're the only one giving out money in this relationship. You're the only one giving it attention. You're the only one always empathizing with them. You're the only one, you know, doing everything in this relationship, but your partner seems to have taken a back seat and they're just watching you drop dead with all that effort. It is not worth it. Number 7 is chronic anger. If your partner is always angry, acting out angrily, venting out, and controlling you with their anger in a way that, you know, you have to act in a manner not to provoke them to be angry. And sometimes it cannot even be directly to you. You find that they are venting out to maybe strangers even in the street. They're venting out to their neighbors. You know, they're just venting out to their colleagues. It's not an exception. People that have anger management issues are just toxic. Number 8 is there's no growth. When you realize that your relationship, you're always starting over, you know, you're always breaking up, starting again, you're always having the same fights, and then sometimes even the issues, the conflicts are not resolved. It's just a sign that this relationship is not growing. And anything that is not growing is definitely dying. So this relationship may not survive in the near future. Number 9 is abuse. Abuse in whatever sense, that is, be it physical abuse, be it emotional abuse. Abuse is just abuse, and it is not anything that should be entertained in a relationship where someone belittles you. I mean, a relationship, you're supposed to be growing together. Your partner is supposed to be encouraging you. They're supposed to be your number one fan. But you realize that they are your number one critics. And it's not just positive critique. It is actually in a negative way. They belittle you. They make you feel, you know, insignificant. Others will also just not be there for you emotionally. You see, you want them, maybe you're going through an issue and you just want them to be that shoulder to lean on. And they're just not there, you know, they just don't care. Others, you could even be sick. You want them to just come around and help you through this distress. But my friend, they're just not there for you. And so all this kind of abuse should not just be entertained. And also not be ignored. Last but not least is intuition. We're told that our gut feelings are always right. There's always a time you want to do something and you just feel like, no, it just doesn't feel right. Same to our relationships. Listen to your gut feeling. Your body has a way it's communicating to you. It can be telling you, no, hey, this level, don't go, don't just try this level, or maybe don't even bother with this person. But if you're not sensitive enough to listen to what your body's telling you, then you'll just miss on this sign. Respect your gut feeling. Stop and listen to what your intuition has to say and just obey it. It will help you. And so the 10 pointers that we've just talked about, that is communication, lies, fear, insecurity, exploitation, control, we've talked about no growth, chronic anger, abuse, and finally intuition. All these 10 pointers will help you to just diagnose what kind of relationship you're in. Is it toxic? Is it healthy? Is it worth fighting for? Is it worth staying? And in the end, you realize that it saved you a great deal to be able to learn these pointers. I wish you happy relationships. I wish you relationships that blossom, and let our relationships glorify and honor God. I'd like to end this video here. And if you've not subscribed, please click the subscribe button. It is absolutely free. Just click the subscribe button and the notification bell to help you get the notification when a video comes up. Thank you for now. Goodbye. Till next time.